gang, I'm gonna write. I'm gonna write, guys. Schwarz, oh, yeah.
Oh, shit, are we live? Oh, sorry, man.
Jessica, we are live.
Sorry, man. Hey, shalom, welcome back to my channel. There's a boy in 2C, you know the vibes, you know what time it is. Yo, dog, I'm very excited actually today. I'm reacting to one of my favorite genres today. It's an authentically South African, you know, genre. I feel like right now you can kind of like put Ama Piano on the same level as, you know, Kwaito, house music. I don't really think that house music is actually South African. But like Kwaito. And then when you actually go to like West Africa, I can actually talk about Afrobeats and I think in Ghana. And then it's actually called High Life. So yeah, man, I'm very excited actually today. So I'm going to be reacting to one of my favorite. This is probably my favorite. I'm actually on the song that's actually been hard like in the past year. I actually got into like late last year. I actually wanted to review this beautiful EP by DJ Stogie. I'm not actually sure if I should actually like review this song before or after. So I really really like the song. I feel like it actually is like two of my favorite Ama Piano vocalists, you know, Cetrio and Marumba Pitch. I think Marumba Pitch is a group, but I think that the leading gent, the leading vocalist, I don't know his name, but I just know him as Marumba. So we're just gonna call him Marumba Pitch, you know. And we've got Cetrio as well. I thought that the song is really beautiful, man. And it actually interpolate Johnny Clegg's Asimbonanga, the song that's actually an ode to Mandela. I mean, like some of the songs here on the EP, like Stokoloko, it actually samples Platform One, Isencane. And yeah, like the whole EP somewhat like pays homage to African classic music, which is really nice, man. And the song, they kind of like also paying homage to the amazing DJ that is Stogie. So yeah, man, let's just get into it. This is actually the part where they actually interpolate Johnny Clegg's Asimbonanga, the hook. So obviously you guys can hear it as well. So Obviously, Dira has actually been doing this with Bomb, but
She was the first one to actually like, you know, rap on a piano, like on a piano beat or on a piano beat. So I think like she's one of the pioneers actually of the genre, man. So I think like the people actually need to show respect to Kamu Pila. So and there's a song called I'm a Nigini Girl, whatever it is. So yeah, man, like it reminded me of that. But so yeah, man, that's it, man. I'm a piano is actually like a very beautiful genre. Like I think if you don't like I'm a piano, just being a hater for real, man. Like this is actually a very beautiful genre. I think it's also, it has actually opened doors to people that are not actually like comfortable in rapping in English. Or like obviously with hip hop, it's somewhat, you know, people that are actually just like comfortable in the neck, are actually looked down upon. Or there's like, I think with hip hop, there's somewhat like there's gatekeeping of some sort, you know. So I think with I'm a Piano, I think like kids or just anyone who's actually like comfortable in their mother tongue or in their language can actually just, you know, just hop on and just, you know, be comfortable and beat and whatever. So it's really nice to actually just also see how, you know, how the genre is actually like, you know, made people rich, and you know, people are actually feeling a family now with the genre, and like, you know, just authentically South African sound can actually do this. It's really dope, man, you know. So yeah, man, shout out to everyone, man. Shout out to all the pioneers of Ama Piano. You know, so yeah, man, that's about it, man. I hope you guys enjoy this, and we'll see you guys in the next video. Shalom.